at 6.
Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News at 6.
Police are investigating what they are calling an accidental shooting early this morning. It happened at the 911 center in Bell County, leading to the death of a young dispatcher. WYMT's Jade Saylor spoke with Kentucky State Police about the incident.
Early this morning, Kentucky State Police Post 10 received a call from the Bell County Sheriff's Department about an accidental shooting.
We dispatched troopers along with detectives to the scene. Through our investigation, we was able to determine that two dispatchers were inside at the time. They were trading firearms while working.
One of the guns accidentally went off, hitting 23-year-old dispatcher Kyle Garrett, who was taken to the Pineville Community Health Center, where he was pronounced dead.
An autopsy is now set up for him. But at this time, you know, it's still early. We're still investigating to figure out what led up to this, what caused the firearm to be discharged.
The department has protocols in place to prevent incidents like this, but it was discovered after the incident that those protocols were not followed.
It's just a very, very sad day here in Bell County to know that, you know, these dispatchers were at work and for something like this to occur.
Leaving the community and first responders to cope with dispatcher Garrett's death.
You know, our prayers go out to the families involved and we're just devastated over it.
Gun trading is a hobby in Eastern Kentucky, and Trooper Shane Jacobs encourages using caution when handling guns.
Well, obviously in Eastern Kentucky, many folks here have firearms. And we just want to make sure that if you are in possession of a firearm, you have that, make sure you always treat it as if it's loaded. Never have it pointed at anyone, and just be very careful.
In Bell County, Jade Saylor, WYMT Mountain News.
Just a terrible story. The investigation into what caused the gun to go off in the first place is still ongoing. If you enjoy camping at Cumberland Gap National Historical Park, you may want to take this into consideration. Park officials say due to recent bear activity, they are closing three backcountry campsites through December 18th. These include Hensley Horse Gap, Chadwell Gap, and Martin's Fork. Officials remind park visitors to take precautions to avoid bears during their visit. New COVID-19 cases and deaths remain high here in the Commonwealth today. The state reported 2,813 new cases, bringing our statewide case total now to 794,816. We had 40 new deaths, putting the Commonwealth's total deaths now at 11,091. The positivity rate stayed about the same. It's sitting at 9.21%. You can always find the latest COVID-19 information on our website at WYMT.com. After 2 months of searching, a missing Southern Kentucky man was found, but it was not the reunion his family wanted. Instead, they have serious questions about the circumstances surrounding the Pulaski County man's death. The sheriff says it's too early to label this anything but a death investigation. WYMT's Phil Pendleton has more on that investigation taking place in the Science Hill community.
Roy Chumbly left his home near Science Hill on October 2nd, leaving behind two key items and a lot of questions from his family.
He left without his cell phone and his cigarettes, and anybody that knows Roy knows that he doesn't go anywhere without his cell phone.
That disappearance also happened not long after Chumbly was charged after police say he struck a woman walking on Anderson Valley Road. The citation says she didn't want to pursue charges, but the detective says her family wasn't so forgiving.
Her family members or friends had then in turn beat him up, but this was prior to that. He'd went to jail, got a DUI charge out of that.
The Pulaski County Sheriff says it's simply too early to say if there was foul play involved in Chumbly's death. In addition, they say that it's too early to say whether that DUI incident had anything to do with his disappearance and his death as well. But his family questions all of this, and they say where and how his body was found have them believing this was no accident or natural causes death.
I just don't think it's possible. Even if he had took off walking and fell, I still don't think they would have found his body that far down. Even with the rain, I don't think it would have still that part out.
The sheriff's detective says the discovery of Chumbly's body was the result of numerous searches involving rescue crews and emergency management. In Pulaski County, Phil Pendleton, WYMT Mountain News.
The state medical examiner will determine Chumbly's cause and manner of death. It's not known how long that process could take. Students at Clay County and Middlesboro High Schools had the opportunity to visit with First Lady Brittany Beshear this week. The First Lady visited students who participate in the Jobs for America's Graduates Kentucky, or JAG, program on Wednesday. The First Lady said in a Facebook post, quote, "Kentucky has a bright future with students like these, and JAG will help these students achieve their dreams." She also worked with a group of students at Middlesboro High School to complete a spaghetti marshmallow challenge that encourages students to work together.
A warm and breezy one around the mountains today. Had a few clouds try to work in there as the sun began to set, but otherwise, we've stayed warm and mild this evening. Out there, you see our time-lapse camera from I-75 in London. Not much in the way of cloud cover. We saw just a few of those clouds towards sunset. Otherwise, the sun setting just fine. And out at Mount Vernon, a similar story just up the road, with things moving quite smoothly this evening. Highs today were quite warm. Got up into the low 70s in many spots. 72 Somerset, London, and Hazard. 73 the warm spot in Williamsburg. A little bit cooler, though, into the Big Sandy. We're still at 66 right now, Jackson and Williamsburg, and mostly low to middle 60s around the region so far. Few clouds to our north, few clouds to our south. We're sitting in the sweet spot right now. Don't have to worry about anything in terms of cloud cover at the moment. We're in the upper 40s to near 50 overnight, as mostly clear skies continue. I'll have the latest on when we could see some showers return coming up in just a few minutes. Steve?
All right, Evan, thank you very much. Well, two Kentucky broadcast legends made a pit stop today in Hazard. Tom Leach and Mike Pratt recently released their first book titled Kentucky Basketball, Two Decades Behind the Scenes. The book relives several moments in their 20-year broadcasting career, giving fans a chance to reminisce. Leach says to celebrate the occasion, they are hosting many book signings, the first one being today in Hazard at the Red Spotted Newt.
This part of the state is, as always has been, as rabid for Kentucky, for fans of the Wildcats, as any part of the state. So it's a great place to do our first book signing.
Great to see the voice of the Wildcats in Hazard today. Pratt says other upcoming stops will be in Lexington. It includes Joseph Beth on Saturday at noon and the UK bookstore on Sunday at noon. Officials in Floyd County recently signed the deed to the land to build a new park. Adjacent from Betsy Lane Elementary sits a large empty lot, but officials say there will soon be plenty to do on that space. Crews are working to clear the land of any brush, as you can see, but this time next year there will be a t-ball field, basketball courts, picnic shelters, a walking track, and more. We spoke to Floyd County Judge Executive Robbie Williams today about the project.
We're excited. We're excited for the kids here locally. This is something there's been a need here for a long time, and it works out really well with the school being next door that the kids can use the park.
Williams also says this could not have been possible without State Representative Ashley Tackett Lafferty, as well as many other officials in the county. Williams says the park is expected to be finished in about a year. Well, big news for Pikeville this afternoon. They won their sixth state football title, defeating Russellville in a catfight 30-27. WYMT's Camille Gear joins us now live from Kroger Field to talk about how much their MVP meant to the win. Camille?
Yeah, Steve, like you just said, Pikeville winning their sixth state championship today in school history and their second in 3 years. But they couldn't have done it today without Blake Birchfield. The junior running back ran for two touchdowns and 179 yards, earning him the title of MVP. Now, Birchfield says even though the Panthers got the ball back late in the fourth quarter, he still wanted to get a couple of more yards to seal the deal.
You know, we didn't know much about what they were going to do up front. You know, we had a few ideas, but we weren't for certain. So we had to mix it up a little bit and do things we usually don't do. And we had a little frustrating third half or third quarter there, but we bounced back in the fourth and pulled it out. Everybody was celebrating there at the final seconds, and I was like, no, there's a few seconds left. We got to finish it out, be focused. And so, yeah, we pulled it out.
Now, one of three Mountain teams are done for the weekend. Next up is Johnson Central versus Boyle County here at 8 o'clock. Now, I will have more on that game coming up in just a little bit in sports. But until then, Steve, back to you.
Camille, thank you very much. As Pikeville celebrates its victory, Johnson Central warms up to put it all on the line, and Belfry prepares to do the same tomorrow. And the presence of Mountain athletes is the talk of Kroger Field. WIMT's Buddy Forbes shares a look into the bleachers where the boys' biggest fans are cheering them on.
From the Friday night lights to the final fights at Kroger Field.
They just put in work after work every day, and in the summer, they just put so much work into this, and it's obviously paying off.
The 606 is in the stands.
Oh, yeah. Mountain pride always.
As Pikeville, Johnson Central, and Belfry High School each make a run for the state championship.
The 606 coming in.
Yes, sir, my brother! Yeah!
Some rushing for the maroon.
Go Panthers!
Some rallying for Matney.
These Mountain boys know how to play football, and it's just awesome to come down here.
Some just ready for a comeback.
Well, you know, it's big for Pikeville to be here, and we got a lot of fans here, but we're here also rooting on the other teams that's coming from our area down here. We just hope all three of them let's bring it home to the mountains.
But all of them representing the mountains.
It's awesome. It's my brother's last high school game, so I'm just excited to see him play and end it here at Kroger Field.
It's my cousin's last game, and it always makes me emotional because me and him are so close.
Dropping hometown rivalries on the Mountain Parkway.
Oh, that's crazy. I'm so proud of all of them. Like, it's just so cool that our whole community is going to be here today and tomorrow. It's just awesome.
Coming together.
Well, we just love seeing everyone in the mountains, just how competitive we are and how successful we get to be.
To cheer on the mountain teams. In Lexington, Buddy Forbes, WIMT Mountain News.
Well, of course, Pikeville secured their state championship this afternoon. Johnson Central, as Camille mentioned, hitting the field soon. That game's expected to start around 8 o'clock tonight. And the stands are still sprinkled with support from back home as the Golden Eagles hope to bring home the gold. Of course, a very emotional season for Johnson Central after the death of Coach Jim Matney earlier this year. Belfry will play tomorrow at noon. We're going to have much more from Lexington later in sports and tonight at 11 and on Sports Overtime.
Warm weather continues into the weekend, but more showers aren't far away. I'll have the very latest coming up.
And the holiday spirit is alive and well in Leslie County, where a partnership is allowing toys to be handed out to children across the county.
WIMT News app offers alerts on breaking stories as they happen, customized to the categories you choose. The WIMT News